In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect a Shure Axient digital radio mic receiver to a Yamaha sound console. The Yamaha sound console has inbuilt Shure control plugin, which allows us to control and monitor the receiver from the desk rather than from the receiver itself. There's lots of benefits to this. If we look at one of the handheld transmitters, obviously we have the SM58 capsule on the top. Right after the capsule is an analog to digital converter, which means that from the point of capture, the signal is entirely digital until it reaches the console. If we were to come out of the XLR port on the back of the receiver and go into the console, then we'd be converting back to analog essentially and going into the console, and then we're using an analog gain on the channel strip of the console. Coming in over the Dante network means that we're keeping everything digital even as it travels to the console, which helps us to keep the signal clean and accurate. And the great thing is the gain control on the channel strip of the console for each receiver channel then actually becomes the sensitivity of the capsule rather than an analog gain of the preamp. So I've got everything set here already on my console. Hopefully either you're already familiar with setting up a QL1 or a Yamaha console, and if you're not, then there's a previous video which I'd recommend you watch. The first thing we need to do, as with any bit of kit, is a factory reset. This means that any settings anyone's put on before this are wiped off, and we're starting from the same spot every time we set up. So I'm going to hit the control wheel, device configuration, scroll down to the bottom, and factory reset. We'll reset the device. Enter to continue. There we go. So this will take a little while now to reset. Okay, so now we're reset. The first thing it's vital to do is to put this receiver into the correct range. So I'm going to hit control wheel again, device configuration, device RF, RF band. Now this defaults to G53. The mics we have at Eclipse are in the G56 band. So I'm going to scroll through to G56, hit enter. So now we'll be able to sync our mics to this receiver. This is extra important when you get into looking to setting this up using wireless workbench. It's very important to start at the right place. The next thing we want to do is to configure the network settings on this device. At the back of the device, there are four network ports, and there's two configurations this can be in. We either have switched mode or split redundant mode. What split redundant does, which is where the device defaults to, is it gives us two Dante ports and two control ports. So you'd connect Dante 1 to your primary network, Dante 2 to your secondary network, etc. And the same with the control. Switched mode enables us to turn those four ports in the back of the receiver into essentially a network switch, with every port carrying control and Dante audio information. This also lets us daisy chain multiple devices together. So I'm going to go into the menu again and go to network configuration. And I'm going to click setup. So you see split redundant is where the device is defaulted to. I'm going to change that to switched mode and hit enter. So this is going to reboot the device again while it's applying these settings. Okay, so that's rebooted and our new settings are applied. The final step we need to do before we connect this to our network is to give it a name so that the Dante network, and specifically the Yamaha console, can recognize it. So when we set up our Rio in a previous video, we gave it the ID Y001. This is the naming protocol that Yamaha uses, so we need to do the same thing for this device. So once again, into the menu structure, down to device audio and Dante names, Dante device name. At the moment it sets it off. I'm going to change this to Yamaha, give it the Yamaha naming protocol. And we already have a device 001 on our network, that's the Rio. And as you would have seen in a previous video, the desk was already set up with virtual devices for ID 2 and 3 being another Rio and a virtual sound card connection. So I'm going to change this to ID 4 so it's unique on the network. So that's done. So now we need to connect this to our network. So what I'm going to do is take a network cable, plug it into any of the ports on the back of this device, and then into the primary connection on my Dante network. So now we're connected to the network, hopefully we're going to be able to find this radio receiver on the network. So I'm going to go to setup, Dante setup, and in device mount, you see here's our Rio from before and our two virtual slots. So in four, I'm just going to click here, and online device lists, there we are, there's our Shure receiver. So I'm going to select that. If I was to press device identify here, then the LEDs on the front of the receiver would light up, just so we know we've got the right one. But we've only got one, so let's add that in. And in just a second, I should get a notification to say it's found it. So there we are, IO device 4 connected. Close that. So now if I go to our list of IO devices, I can see this receiver and all of the information. What we haven't done is tell the outputs of this device to go to channels on the Dante network. So I'm just going to quickly go to Dante patch, input patch, and set Dante channel 1 to 4 to be inputs 1 to 4 from this device. So now on our Dante patch list, we can see Dante 1 to 4 are taken from Y004 instead of 001 like the other channels. Now if I go to one of my input channels and set the input to Dante 1, there we go. Let's go to the other four channels as well. Now our first four channels on the desk are set to take the input from Dante channels 1 through to 4, and we can see on the headamp information, we've got receiver gain rather than analog gain like we would have previously had. And if I just bring this up and go to the 8-channel view, there we can see for each of these four channels, the receiver gain, the RF level, and battery level if there was a device connected. We can also see here the frequency of each channel. If you want to change this, then we have to do it on the receiver, but the gain is now controlled from the console rather than on the receiver. Okay, so now our desk and our receiver are talking to each other. The next thing we need to do would be to put in our frequencies and manage our mics for our show.